It's adding a lot of complexity to what is, I think, already, among the most complex trade agreements that you can try to negotiate. And, one of the things that happens with the NBA issue is, all of us on CNBC or in D.C., we spend a lot of time on politics and economics. Culture trumps both of those in the minds of people and consumers. So it does have, it does cross over into areas where consumers, people going into retail shops start to think about those things. Now, we haven't seen that kind of thing happen in the past here. We have seen that kind of thing happen in China, though. And so it's a real risk for American firms that are doing business over there.
You know, from the market standpoint, Tony, I think the biggest question is whether or not there will be relief from tariffs and whether or not the next tranche of tariffs will go into effect. Do you think we'll get progress on that? Or will that remain something that's in play, even if there are agreements that are reached at the table, simply because the U.S. will have little leverage to make sure that China actually complies with anything that is agreed upon unless there are things like tariffs in place?
Yeah, that's true. Like, I think a comprehensive agreement is nearly impossible to do with all of these things that are being thrown into the bucket right now. And it's, it's always going to be difficult. You throw in the national security issues, makes it, really hard to negotiate. And then I also think you have the issue of President Trump going through this impeachment process right now and him looking as a weak person. So I think a weak leader, and the Chinese questioning, who are they actually negotiating with? Are they negotiating with someone who's actually going to be there tomorrow? So that's an issue. I think they do want to get some kind of an agreement. It would bring a lot of relief on both sides of the Pacific and in those economies and in markets. I think markets would rally even on a really skinny kind of an agreement, and that would bode well for continuing talks in the future. I think that's the best that we can hope for right now. It's not a slam dunk that that's going to happen, though, because of some of these issues that have cropped up over the past week that Kayla ran through.
Obviously, Tony, the Chinese do not like to be lectured. They do not like to be told what to codify in their laws with respect to, for example, the protections of intellectual mm-hmm. property. Let's set that aside for the moment. I'm interested in hearing you describe what you would tell American businesses mm-hmm. about what they or their employees can fairly and safely say about Chinese, quote, domestic politics while they continue to do business there. It's not as if Hong Kong is the first sort of evidence of foul play on the part of the Chinese government that we're aware of.
No,
they have been persecuting the Tibetans. They have
Uyghurs.
Been persecuting the Muslims. And they have lots of political prisoners. And yet, dozens of American companies do billions of dollars of business within that country every year.
Yeah. Look, I think it's unrealistic to tell global American corporations not to do business in China, and it's also unrealistic to tell their employees that you can't use your voice. They are, at the end of the day, American companies. I will tell you what we tell our clients and we tell American companies is to set your principles. What are your principles? And be open and public about them. Publish them. Tell the Chinese and others, what principles you have for what your expectations are for your managers and your employees, and just be very clear about it and go into those markets based on those principles. And you can have a really good discussion about them, and I think you could do them in a way that the Chinese will actually understand them. It's difficult for firms like the Siemens of the world and the big retailers and Boeing and
Microsoft,
others,
the John Deere,
right.
General Motors, all
they
of
have,
them.
They have global competition. My issue here with the NBA is NBA is essentially a monopoly. There's only one NBA in the world. There's not a clear number two. The number two is 100 steps down mm-hmm. Relative to the NBA. The NBA actually has some power here. The problem with the NBA is that they're uneven in what they what they expect from their people and their teams. So you can't criticize China, but you can criticize Turkey. And a general manager isn't allowed to say something, but a player is allowed to say something. And so they're not clear on what their principles are and what they're about. I know that You know, they have tried to come out with a couple statements now to clear that up, and they haven't. Maybe they haven't quite done it, but they needed to get. They needed to go in to, as their business model, as their business strategy, knowing what those principles are and the expectations are.
We're all hopped up about this issue, and you look on any cable news channel right now, you will see this debate taking place across the board.
Yeah.
Let's be clear here. Daryl Morey was speaking as Daryl Morey. He wasn't speaking on behalf of the Houston Rockets, clearly. He wasn't speaking on behalf of the National Basketball Association. So how long does this story play out before another shiny object comes along and we're all distracted and it goes away?
Well, it could happen soon. I mean, you know, because these things are happening every day and they're big. And, you know, we as Americans care about these kinds of issues just as much as, you know, if the Chinese care, that we know that they care about Hong Kong. We care about freedom and democracy. I'll tell you the Chinese Canadian owner of the Brooklyn Nets, you know, said some things about the situation that offended me. And we don't look at it and say, well, he shouldn't be allowed to say those things and NBA's got to shut him up. We say, no, in America, you could say what you believe. So there are sort of foundational principles that we believe in. And so the firms need to go into these markets clear on those things and public about them. And so there are no surprises.